When popovers are made correctly, they have a delicious golden brown crust on the outside and a light, airy texture on the inside. And today, I'm gonna show you how to make perfect popovers. To start, I'm going to need 3 eggs. Now, the most important ingredient here in making popovers is steam. And steam comes from a lot of different liquids in the batter. So 3 eggs to start this process off. And I'm going to whisk the eggs together with 1.5 cups of whole milk. Now, I have all of my ingredients at room temperature, and you want to make sure that your batter in the end is at room temperature, so it will help to develop the steam. So whisk these 2 ingredients together until they're nice and frothy. You wanna incorporate a little bit of air here, and that takes about 1 minute. So my egg and milk mixture is nice and frothy. These bubbles in the end will help create the rise of the popover. To this, I'm going to add 1.5 cups of all-purpose flour, and of course, salt, very important, 1.25 teaspoons of coarse salt. So whisk this together until it's combined, but there can be a few lumps. You don't need to overmix the batter. That will toughen up your popovers. So you're looking for the consistency of heavy cream, maybe a few lumps. And popovers, they're of the same family as Yorkshire pudding, their English cousin, also Dutch baby pancakes. They're one of those nice, delicious, eggy batters. Okay, so this is ready to go. It's about the consistency of heavy cream with a few lumps in it. If you wanted to flavor your batter in any way, adding some spice, maybe some herbs, you could do that at this time. So I have a popover pan preheating in my oven. I'm gonna go grab that. So my popover pan has been in the oven preheating at 425 degrees. I have it on a sheet tray, and the sheet tray actually helps to conduct heat, which will encourage the popovers to rise even more. I'm using a little bit of nonstick cooking spray. Spray each of the cups liberally. Take your batter, and you wanna fill each cup up 3/4 of the way with the batter. And this room temperature batter in these hot cups will immediately start to cook. You can almost hear them. And this whole rising process, all of that steam that's gonna be generated is going to create such nice lofty popovers. So 3/4 of the way full, right back into that 450 degree oven. You're gonna bake them for 20 minutes and then you're gonna reduce the temperature down to 350 and bake for another 20 until they've puffed up over the pan and they're dry to the touch and of course, golden brown and delicious. So the popovers look great. They've actually popped over the cups here. Now what you wanna do is remove them immediately to a wire rack. And a little trick in maintaining the shape is to take a small paring knife and you wanna create a little slit in the popovers, and this helps to release any steam. And what it will do is it'll help preserve the shape a little bit longer so you don't have to rush to get them to the table. However, I don't think you're going to want to wait because these are the most delicious popovers. Now serve them with some butter, maybe some jam, and there you go, guys. Look at the interior is nice and light and airy. And there it is, popover perfection. Enjoy.